So if you're new to my channel, hello, my name is Gurush Kaur, and girl, today's video is completely dedicated to base makeup. Because regardless of how many hours you spend blending your shadows, if your base is not looking cute, girl, it's not a cute look in totality. You in the middle. I would like to tell you that I am a dry skin type and currently my skin is supremely dry, so it is my absolute duty to really hydrate my skin well before jumping into the actual makeup side of things. And guys, do not, regardless of whatever skin type you are, you cannot skip your skin prep. Your base cannot look good if you're not wearing a moisturizer underneath, like the bare minimum. So I just washed my face and have no trace of skincare on my face. So I'm just gonna jump into my regular skincare routine. I'm trying to include all affordable products in here and, you know, do the minimal steps to achieve a flawless base that also gonna last you a good long time. So yeah, do catch up with me. Okay, so I'll try to keep a majority of the products as affordable and from the drugstore category as possible, but I just realized I do not have a very affordable toner in my collection, so I'm just gonna go ahead and use my Kiehl's toner. But you can most certainly use whichever toner you like or go for in daily use. So yeah, I like to take a couple of drops of the toner on my palm, rub it between my hands and press it on my skin. And as for my current skincare routine, I like to use this Sugandha 10% niacinamide serum. So again, I just like to take 3 to 4 drops on my palm, rub it between my hands, and I just use the niacinamide serum for the sole purpose as it is a part of my current skincare routine, as currently I'm breaking out pretty damn bad, like these are hurting acne. So yeah, I have personally included niacinamide serum in my routine currently, but you can just do with a toner and moisturizer for real. And for my moisturizer today, I'm gonna use the Garnier Wrinkle Lift Moisturizer. Put it all over my face and neck. And since I belong to the really dry skin category and my skin does, you know, tend to develop dry skin patches, you know, throughout the day when I wear foundation most of the time, so I like to include a facial oil, and the one I'm going to use is by Miracle Herbs. It's their Radiance Face Treatment Oil. This is my second bottle. I have not loved a facial oil this much lately. Do you guys want like a complete review of this facial oil? Do let me know in the comments below. I would love to review it for you all. And again, take like 4 drops. And we surely do not want chapped lips when we reach to the lipstick application part. So I'm surely gonna use the Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask. This stuff is so good. So our skin prep is beautifully done and the skin already looks cute without any makeup. So next comes priming your face, and priming your face is kind of debatable in the beauty community. Some people are like high on it, like you cannot skip a primer. Some people are like, duh, you don't need a primer. I'm somewhere in the middle ground. Use a primer only if you need it, and also recognize the reason why you're using a primer. I'll just explain real quick. So basically, if you're just using a hydrating primer to hydrate your skin and make the makeup last longer and the foundation stick to your skin well, you can just go in with great skin prep, like really nicely moisturize and hydrate your skin, and you do not need a hydrating primer. Whereas if you have more of a pore issue that most of the people have, like around this area, the cheeks, on the side of your nose and on your nose especially, you might want to use a pore filling primer. Trust me, even I skip my primer every now and then because of the religious skincare routine that I follow prior to my foundation. Your base is still gonna look bomb. I mean, the last thing you wanna do is put foundation on bare skin. Nope, honey. Not recommended. And thirdly, if you have extremely oily skin, you might want to use a mattifying primer to mattify your skin slightly so that your makeup lasts longer. So only if you want like a hydrating primer, you can do without it, sis. So today I've picked a pore filling primer, that is the Zero Pore Primer by Pat Cosmetics. It's basically a clear silicone based primer, so I'm not gonna overdo it. Just go in with like one pump. That's a good lot of product. Again, I like to massage all my products between my fingertips to warm them up. It's just a thing I do always. And it's a clear silicone based primer and just really fills in your pores. Like you can feel it giving you a smooth canvas. So to save you guys of some boredom, I'm just gonna quickly go off camera to do my brows and we'll be right back in a second. Okay, so she's back with the brows on and let's start with the actual base makeup. So I've tried to include a majority of like affordable products in there so that any one of you can recreate it easily and, you know, get access to similar products that are more budget friendly, I believe. So yeah, we're gonna address the most common question that I get as a beauty blogger, that how to hide dark circles, how to not make my under eyes look gray or ashy. I'm gonna tell you why it looks gray or ashy and how to actually counteract that. So as humans, we all have some sort of darkness underneath or around our eyes, and that's completely normal. So the reason a majority of people's under eyes and pigmentation around their mouth, that area like in specific, looks slightly ashy and gray is because they directly go in with like a highlighting concealer, and that sure contrasts with the pigmentation underneath and makes it look a little more ashy, and that surely is not the best look. So what we're going to do to counteract that is basically use a concealer that is more warmer and more orange toned, not a literally orange concealer, but something that has orangey peachy undertones to it. So a concealer with more warmer orangey undertones will basically neutralize discoloration and darkness underneath your eyes and around your mouth. And the one I chose for today is the Darling Isabella concealer. It's in the shade 06 Warm Gold Supreme. This is a supremely inexpensive concealer. It has like mediumish coverage, sheer to medium coverage, thereby it is actually great as an underneath concealer or corrector, because in this case we don't need hell a lot of coverage, just that slight color correction. And the way I like to use it is dot it slightly underneath my eyes. If you notice, I'm using a very small amount of product around my mouth as well, and just simply buff in this concealer. All it will do is neutralize all the discoloration on your problematic areas. So you can either use a beauty sponge or even your fingers for that matter. So I'm gonna do half of my face with like a beauty sponge and half with literally just my hands. And or I also like to use it on my pigmentation, scarring, acne marks. So yes, my face does look a lot yellowy, orangier than it should be because just the color corrector that has been laid down. But can you notice how with just that small tiny amount of product, the face already looks so much more neutralized and all the discoloration is pretty much gone. So this way you don't have to layer a lot of products one on the other and your makeup will look flawless for a longer time. So yeah, I really believe that you should add more product only when and where you require more coverage, because when you layer a lot of product on top of each other, like for regular wear when you go out, it's surely gonna crease and crack a lot more earlier than it's supposed to. So after the color correction, I like to go ahead with my foundation, and you have to choose your foundation according to your skin type. As I already stated a gazillion times, I belong to the dry skin category and just naturally I'm more attracted to dewy finish foundations. And for that today, I'm going to use the LA Girl Pro Illuminating Foundation in the shade Nude Beige. So I always like to start with like little and then build it up again when and wherever required. So I like to take like 1.5 pumps of this foundation, that's almost this much, and actually dot it all across my face to know where exactly I need product. I'm gonna do this side of my face with a beauty sponge. If you would have noticed, I've not applied foundation like right underneath my eyes because I do not want 3, 4, 5 layers of product underneath my eyes. We all naturally have lines and wrinkles, like slight wrinkles underneath our eyes, so try to avoid putting a lot of product underneath there, because despite all the techniques you use, it is gonna slightly crease up because it's skin after all, I mean. And with whatever's left on my sponge, I just like to take it onto my forehead The same logic that we used with under eyes, our forehead, at least mine, also does get a lot of lines and stuff when we make expressions. So you don't want to layer a lot of product in there. And I just take whatever's remaining on the butt of my sponge all across my forehead to just give it a nice even coat of color, but not really looking for heavy coverage in there. And for the rest of my face, I'm going to use my good old fingers. And when using your fingers, do take care that you're patting the foundation instead of dragging it, because it's gonna be a hot mess that way. Can I just say that fingers are literally the best makeup tools. They warm up the product pretty well, do not lose on any coverage, and just gives you this flawless finish. And to buff the foundation on my neck, I like to go in with a kabuki brush. Okay, so you can right away go and set your face with some powder, but I actually like to add in like a very small amount but of a highlighting concealer to bring out my features a little more just underneath my eyes and underneath my bottom lip to really bring out my main features out there. So I don't like to go in with like a super light concealer, but something in the middle that is like just one shade lighter than my concealing shade. So the one I'm going to use is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer. It's in the shade medium, and I'm not going to draw too big inverted triangles underneath my eyes. It's not Instagram, it's real life flawless makeup. So I'm just gonna dab a little bit of product. It does not have to be in any particular shape. Just concentrate a majority of the product in the inner corner, so you get that like really bright inner corners, and just a tad bit underneath the bottom lip. And that's pretty much it. Just go in with your blender and blend that out. Also, start blending out the edges of the concealer first to also not lose on the coverage. Like, don't go directly on top, like on top of the concealer. Go around the edges of the concealer to first merge that in with your cheek, and then very slightly go on top of the actual part where you want the most coverage. So I'm just gonna go slightly around the edges to fade them into the foundation. And once that is done nice and neat, just go in with a very light hand, and with the rest of the concealer on the beauty sponge, I just like to go all over my eyelids to cancel out any discoloration there. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Okay, so my face does crease very, very quickly. So I just went ahead and powdered and set my face, but I'm not gonna explain how I did it and how to do it in a way that, you know, it does not look very cakey and powdery. I'll just zoom you guys in to see, like, my skin still does not look cakey or powdery, and we are still gonna add like setting spray and stuff to further melt it down. So basically for that, what I like to do is take my loose powder, dunk my beauty sponge into the loose powder. So basically when you do that, a lot of product gets onto the sponge all together. So what I like to do is basically stamp the powder on the back of my hand so that there's only sufficient powder, that is like required amount of powder on your beauty blender that you want to put on your face. So I just stamp on like the extra powder on my hand and then go and press it onto my under eyes. And since the beauty sponge is damped, it just really beautifully sets into all those crease lines, and the makeup looks legit flawless. This hack has been a game changer in my base game for real. So always do not just go in with that heavy amount of powder. I'm personally not a fan of baking, never worked for me, always makes me look like a cakey mess. But this technique has worked amazingly for me, and it's gonna work for all skin types, I believe, not just dry skin. So yeah, and also do get rid of the creases before you do that. So yeah, so here for you all to have a closer look. Can you see how my skin still does not look like extremely powdery or cakey? It looks matte for sure and set, but not powdery or cakey for sure again. So that's all I'm gonna do to contour my face. And if you guys know me, you know I'm a blush person. I love rosy cheeks like anything. So I'm gonna go ahead with actually two blushes. Like if I'm doing something more wearable in real life, I always go ahead with two blushes, and most of the time it's these two by Colabar. So the first blush I'm gonna use is by Colabar. It's the matte illusion blush in the shade Fallen Leaves. It's actually broken, so I'm gonna very carefully open it and apply it on my cheeks. It's broken, yeah, it just broke the other day, but it's such a pretty blush. I'm very soon gonna reorder this one. So I'm gonna very carefully pick the pigment, and since it's broken, there's a lot of pigment on my brush. I'm gonna dust it off, and because this is more of like a burnt orange subdued blush, I like to apply it more like as a bronzer in here towards the upper part of my cheekbone, all the way to my temples. Bring it in here slightly. And for my second blush, I'm going to use the Colabar Cheek Illusion Blush in the shade Sweet Scarlet. This is slightly glowy. Like, it's not shimmer at all. You cannot trace shimmer in the product. It is ever so slightly glowy, whereas that one is extremely matte. This one is like slightly glowy and gives that healthy glow and sheen on your cheeks. So I'm going to pick the blush on the same brush. Dust off the excess, and this time I'm gonna start hitting the apples of the cheeks first, because that is where I want this pinky corally sort of color to be. And I also like to put some blush on my nose, a little on my chin as well, for that overall flushed look. Do not be afraid to put blush. I mean, it's the first thing to fade away from your face. So now I'm gonna try to stop applying more blush, but isn't this looking so pretty? That nice flush of color all over your face, living for it. So before putting on some highlighter, I like to spritz my face with some setting spray, take a nice little shower, and for that I'm gonna use the Wet n Wild Natural Finish setting spray. So to just complete our base, I'm lastly gonna add some highlighter, and for that I'm gonna use the Maybelline Master Chrome Highlighter in the shade Molten Gold. And I just broke this highlighter while the course of this video, but we're gonna ignore that. And if you did watch my brush guide video, you already know that I like to use a precision powder brush to do my highlighter instead of a fan brush. Firstly, because I have more precision and it just makes the highlighter more poppin', in my opinion. Just gonna hit the tops of my cheekbones. It's a pretty damn potent highlighter, so you gotta be careful of the amount you use. Connect the highlighter above my brow bone to my cheekbone so that it's this nice C or V shape going on in here. And on this side as well. Ooh, that's popping. And whatever's left on my brush, I like to take it slightly to my cheeks so that when I look in front and smile, my cheeks are nice and glowy. On my chin, on the tip of my nose, and right in the center or the bridge of the nose. Okay. And if and whenever you feel that you went a little overboard with the highlighter, all I personally like to do is take the MAC Studio Fix Plus, dip my beauty sponge in there. And especially it's for me like around the cheeks, if I went a little too overboard, that it exaggerates my texture or make me look a little too shiny, that it is greasy. So all I do is go slightly underneath my eyes, from starting from the side of my nose to underneath my eyes, to just mattify this portion so that the glow is still there but it does not look excessively greasy or shiny. Okay, so that's all for the base. Now I'm gonna quickly go off camera and complete the rest of my makeup, and we'll be right back. So yeah guys, that's my finished makeup look. The base is full coverage, but in no way, sis, it looks cakey, patchy or dry. So I'm really living for that full coverage yet wearable base. As far as I can see, the skin does look glowy but not overly shiny or greasy. It is matte in places where required and shiny where you want to glow a little. So yeah, as far as I can see, the skin looks like a perfect combination of matte as well as glowy. This base is gonna last you a good long time. It's not gonna crease super quick. This is gonna be pretty much creaseless throughout the day. If you use these techniques, do let me know in the comments below. That's all I got for you for today's video. I hope it helped. Do let me know in the comment section below what more such videos you want to see, and I shall make more of them for you all. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, beauties. See you in my next one.